What's going on, guys? EzAlgo V7 and EzSR are officially live. These are the new updates to our EzAlgo trading indicator, and I'm going to go through a brief walkthrough on how you can get set up and start using these new updates today to help you with your trading. I'm super excited to bring you guys this video. These updates have been something I've been working on for months now, and I'm so glad that they're finally released and that you guys can get to use them and make some great gains using our confluences. So first things first, if you don't have the EzAlgo trading indicator, be sure to click the first link in the description below. This will give you access to three different indicators within EzAlgo. That is the EzAlgo buy and sell signals, the EzSR, and our own momentum indicator, the EzOscillator. Once you do that, you're going to come up here to invite only scripts at the top of trading view. Come down here to invite only scripts and then select EzAlgo V7. We're going to start with this one and then move into the SR shortly after. So when you load in your EzAlgo V7, this is what it will look like on your chart. You'll see we have these buy and sell signals, which are fairly accurate on their own. We also have this trend dashboard in the top right. That was there from our V6. So if you haven't watched the V6 walkthrough, go watch the V6 walkthrough. A lot of our inputs are the same. So I'm just going to be covering what's new in this video. So let's head into settings real quick. The first thing that you'll see we added is this minimalistic toggle. Now, a lot of people don't like the big bulky buy and sell signals. So we just added a B and an S, and you can change the signals offset for these to, let's say, 2. It just helps remove the noise and makes the chart a lot cleaner, right? Personally, I like to see those buy and sell signals with the signals offset of 5, but it's totally up to you. You can even hide the signals altogether by unchecking the show buy and sell. For the signal type, we have the standard buy and sell signals, which are the labels, and then we have the mild buy and sell signals, which are the same from previous updates with those blue and red X's. I'd recommend keeping the signal type as all. The automatic stop loss and take profit is there if you want to use that. You can set your stop loss percent, your take profit 1, 2, and 3. This is great for beginners to learn risk management, to have that invalidation level right in front of you, and also your take profits so you're not as greedy. But for more intermediate to experienced traders, you're not going to want to use this. You're going to want to base your stop loss off of price action right below the previous swing low and targeting different support and resistance levels as your take profit. At least that's what I do. So the automatic stop loss and take profit is entirely up to you. I know a lot of users like to use this. Personally, I like to keep this unchecked. Now moving on to the trend setting. So this is actually a new category. In our previous version, we had an other settings category, but we removed some things and added something. So the first thing that we've added to the inputs tab is this show candle coloring. So this will color all of the candles in a buy signal blue and all the candles in a sell signal red. Now this is super customizable. If you go into style, you can change the bar color. We just added a toggle under trend settings, so it's right there, a little bit easier to navigate. We also have a brand new trend ribbon. Now this is a little bit more delayed than our previous trend ribbon, but I find that the EzOscillator actually is a better trend ribbon in and of itself than our previous one. So we have a new trend ribbon in V7, like I said, a little bit more delayed, a lot smoother, a lot cleaner. This is definitely more useful on a higher time frame to dictate the overall trend of the market. For example, you can see on Uniswap, we get that sell signal, right? The trend ribbon flips to red and you can see that price comes down. Any little pump that you might get in the strong downtrend where all of the trend MAs are face downwards, you're going to be looking to take a sell signal, right? This buy signal is below the trend ribbon. We come up, we get rejected once again. We finally break the trend ribbon and now buy signals are valid. When you see all these trend MA bands starting to tighten up and start curving upwards and you get a buy signal, that is another piece of confluence that the trend could be possibly shifting and that you should start to look for long positions. When you see all four of the trend ribbons have this very downward slope, angle is almost straight down. So on lower time frames, it might be best to look to take short positions, for example. Overall, this is just another added confluence. All right, we also have EMA toggles directly from the inputs, right? So if you don't want to show all three EMAs, you can check and uncheck the ones you want to show. By default, we have the 7, 21, and 144 EMA setup. I know a lot of people like to use the 50 EMA, the 200 EMA when trading stocks and futures. Personally, for crypto, I like to use a 144 EMA, and the 7 and 21 are great as well. All right, next we have the reversal settings, which are the same as the V6. These reversal signals are very, very powerful. We've also added alerts for the reversal signals, which I'll show at the end of V7, but these do a great job at predicting the local tops and bottoms. You can use these on any asset, on any time frame. Don't sleep on the reversal signals. I know a lot of people overlook them, but they are very powerful, especially when combined with key support and resistance levels. Next, we have the reversal bands, right? So the reversal bands are great as well. You can see that every time price touches these reversal bands, happens, especially in a ranging market, you see some sort of reaction, right? So we hit this upper band, price comes down. We tag the band once more, price goes up. Tag it again, price comes down. Tag it again, price goes up. Tag it again, price goes up. These do work best in ranging markets. For example, a clear downtrend with lower lows and lower highs, price will oftentimes hit this band, but price might not react as well as it would in a ranging market. In this case, what you can do is go down to a lower time frame for an entry and maybe try to take a scalp long position when price is approaching these bands, right? For example, right here, you could have gone down to a lower time frame, entered a long, and price came up. And these bands are also non-repaint in real time. So if I go to replay mode, you can see that price comes down, tags that band, and now we're gonna start heading back up. So these are non-repaint. Very important to know, because a lot of these sort of reversal bands on TradingView, or at least a lot of the free indicators and even some paid, are oftentimes repaint indicators. So what's the point of having reversal bands if they're repaint? It doesn't make sense, right? So none of our inputs in any of our EzAlgo products will be repaint. They're all going to be real time. And last but not least, we have the trend dashboard, which shows the overall momentum in the markets. This dashboard is based off of the 144 EMA. So when price is above the 144 EMA, the trend will be bullish, and vice versa for when price is below. Again, this is just another added confluence. You don't want to base your trades solely on whether price is above or below the 144 EMA. But if you see on higher timeframes that price is above the 144 or maybe testing it, it might be best to look for long positions to trade with the trend. And we're going to talk about one last thing before we move on to the SR, and that is Japanese candles versus Heiken Ashi candles. EzAlgo works across both the Japanese and the Heiken Ashi candles. However, the buy and sell signals are created for Heiken Ashi candles. Now, that doesn't mean you can't use them for confluence or even confirmation if you're on Japanese candles, but just keep in mind that they will not be as accurate as they will be on Heiken Ashi candles. Now, something I like to do with these buy and sell signals is go down to a lower time frame, such as the 5 to 15 minute time frame on the Heiken Ashi candles, using support levels from a higher time frame, and look to take scalp long and short positions at these key levels. Now, it's crucial that you're using support from a higher time frame, which you can now use with the new multi-timeframe EzSR levels. But just to show you an example of this in real time, right, we see we have this support here on a higher time frame, right, like on a 2 hour or a 1 hour time frame. So you're looking for a long position from here. So instead of entering on the 1 hour time frame, which would have been a great entry in this case, what you can do is go down to, let's say, a 5 minute time frame, turn on your Heiken Ashi candles with the buy and sell signals, and take each buy signal that's at or near this level, right? So if we go down to the 5 minute time frame, we see we have these reversal signals and then that buy signal on EzAlgo, and price comes up, right? Maybe take a little bit of profit here at this sell signal and then simply re-enter again with that buy signal. The trend ribbon is flipping and you go up over 3%. So in total, like 3.5%. If you're using 50 to 100x leverage, these gains can really compound. Don't sleep on the buy and sell signals on Heiken Ashi candles. Just make sure that when you're using these buy and sell signals and entering off of them, price is at a key support level on a higher time frame, or you're trading with the trend. All right, next we're gonna load in our EzSR. So let's go up here to indicators again. Click on EzSR V2. It's very important that you're using the V2, all right? So not the EzSR, make sure it says V2. So click on that. And once the indicator loads in, this is what it will look like. You'll see support and resistance levels on the time frame that you're currently on. These levels, unlike previous versions, are based on candle body. So you're getting the meat of the support. Previously, we'd have levels here at this candle wick, right? But that doesn't capture the full support and resistance. So this is brand new coding. It took us a long, long time, around 2.5 to 3 months working every day to make sure that these codes are perfect, right? These levels are probably as accurate as you can get. We did lots of trial and error and testing to get these levels to where they are now. And we've also added a multi-timeframe option, meaning you can use higher timeframe levels on the timeframe of your choosing. So let me show you how that works. So come up here into settings. This looks very confusing at first glance, but rest assured, we're going to break down each option so you know exactly how to use. So by default, the multi-timeframe SR1 will be toggled. This will show you the support and resistance levels on the timeframe you are currently on. You can change this to any timeframe of your choosing, but it must be greater than the chart timeframe. So for example, if you're on the daily timeframe, obviously you can't show levels on the 5 minute timeframe. But if you're on the 5 minute timeframe, you can show levels from the daily if you wanted to. What I'd recommend is to use levels on your chart, and then also use levels on a higher time frame, such as the 1 to 4 hour time frame for extra confluence. Now, choosing that other time frame is totally up to you. Personally, I like the 1 hour, the 4 hour, and the daily levels. 2 hour are great as well, but like I said, if you're on a lower time frame, anywhere from 5 to 15 to 30 minutes, I like the 1 hour, the 4 hour, and the daily. When you see confluence with two multi-time frame levels overlapping, that gives you extra confluence that you're going to take along if price reaches that level. Now, to the left of the time frame, we have levels, right? So this is how many levels you want to see on your chart at one time. Now, this is not based on strength, all right? There's already a strength feature built into EzSR, hence why more timeframes will have more levels than others. The maximum amount of levels that you can see on your screen at one time is 7. So if I change the levels to 7, you'll see that we now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is the maximum amount of levels for this particular time frame. If I only wanted to show 5, I can change it to 5, and you'll see that it will remove the furthest level. So like I said, this is not based on strength. This is based on location. So you're only going to be showing the 5 closest levels. Sometimes there won't even be 5 levels on a chart, like I said, because there's already a strength feature built into the levels themselves. But most of the time, you'll see a maximum of 6 to 7 levels on your chart. And especially if you're adding multi-timeframe levels, you don't want to see 7 levels per time frame. Your chart's going to be too cluttered and you're not going to be able to follow what's going on. So keep this at 5 default. It will show the 5 closest levels. Just for example, if I go to 3, it will show the 3 closest levels. 1, 2, 3. We also have some other coding into it. There's a ton of customization features in the EzSR indicator. We have the lines, which you can toggle on and off. Frankly, I like to use the lines off a lot of the time. I like these zones, because oftentimes support and resistance isn't one level on the chart. It's a general zone, right? So that's why we've added zones, which you can also toggle on and off. You can change the width of these zones here. Personally, I like to keep the width at 1, and you can also change the visibility. So if you want the zones to be a little bit darker and more clear, you can change the visibility to 20. I think that looks pretty nice. You can toggle the labels on and off, change the size if you want. The offset for the label dictates how close the labels are to current price. You can choose anywhere from 1, which will be right next to the current price, all the way up to 100, which will be all the way over here. So this is very useful if you're using multi-time frame levels. You don't want the labels to overlap, so we added an offset feature. So you can load in multiple labels and levels on one chart and it will look super clean. And since we're on the 2 hour time frame, let's load in the 8 hour support and resistance level. So we're going to turn on another multi-time frame SR. I only want to see the 3 closest levels, so I'm going to set that to 3. I'm going to turn the zones off for this SR, change the style to solid, and change the width to 3 to kind of make these levels stand out a little bit more. All right, perfect. So now we have the 8 hour support and resistance levels with the 2 hour support and resistance levels on the 2 hour time frame. Now, I wouldn't recommend using more than 2 of these multi-time frame options. Once you get to 3, it kind of makes your chart a little bit too cluttered, in my opinion, but I know some people will like that. So we do have 3 separate options. Now, using these levels is very simple. What you're going to be doing is looking for buys at support, obviously, and sells at resistance, but you want the most amount of confluence as possible. So when you see that you have a higher time frame support or resistance level overlapping a current time frame support or resistance level, that gives you extra confluence to take a trade there. So for example, we have this 8 hour resistance level overlapping directly with the 2 hour resistance level. That tells me if price were to come up to this level, I'd be looking for a double top and looking to take a short position. So my trade would look something like this at the end. Now, it's very important to wait for a reaction at these levels. You don't want to just set a limit all the time. You do want to wait for a reaction. So this could either be a bearish candle, right? Bearish candle, something like this. If you don't know candlestick patterns, we have a candlestick pattern cheat sheet in the Discord. So click the first link in the description below and you'll get the candlestick pattern cheat sheet. It's very important that you guys learn these candle patterns so you know where to look for a rejection. You could also look for a mild sell signal on EzAlgo, or what you can do is go down to a lower time frame, such as the 15 or maybe even 5 minute time frame on the Heiken and Ashi candles, and look to take a sell position when price comes up to this level. All right, I'm here on Aave on the 30 minute time frame just to show you guys another quick example. I have the 1 hour and 4 hour levels pulled up, and you'll notice that in real time, we just rejected both the 1 hour and 4 hour resistance levels. These levels are not repaint levels. They form in real time, and you can see that these levels were actually there before price even came up to these levels. So they're not lagging levels, right? We have a 1 hour 1 hour and 4 hour resistance overlapping each other. Price comes up, breaks that 1 hour resistance, and now we're gonna be looking for a short position, right? Because we have two confluences. We have a 1 hour and a 4 hour resistance. So we're gonna be looking to take a trade somewhere around here. Obviously, we wanna wait for a reaction. Beautiful rejection of both levels. We see we have this bearish candle and we're starting to close below this level. And then we get a mild sell signal. So we're going to enter a short position from here, stop loss above that swing high and targeting this next 4 hour support. We get that EzAlgo sell signal to follow. We react a little bit off this 1 hour support, come back up to tag those resistance levels. And now we're dropping once again. So in real time, this is how you can use the 1 hour and 4 hour levels in confluence. Like I said, if you want a better entry, what you can do is go down to the 5 minute time frame, turn on your buy and sell signals, go to the Heiken Ashi candles and look at, you would have caught that trade perfectly, right? So for the most amount of confirmation, wait for that EzAlgo sell signal on a lower time frame, such as the 5 minute time frame. You see we have those reversal signals. We're at two key levels. We're at a key resistance level on the 1 hour, a key resistance level on the 4 hour, a mild sell signal on EzAlgo, and then a sell signal closing below this level. So this is what I like to do, right? So I'll have two charts pulled up. On one side, I'll have the Japanese candles with the multi-timeframe support and resistances pulled up. And then on the other side, I'll have the 5 minute time frame with the Heiken Ashi candles to try to catch that sell signal going through. And that is how you can achieve a perfect entry. Now, if you want to, you can simply re-enter the short position once again with that sell signal and price is coming down. All right, and I let this trade run in real time and we came right down to this 4 hour support level and we're seeing a reaction off of this level, right, for a long position. So you would have entered the long on the buy signal targeting this 1 hour and 4 hour resistance level up here. Maybe take half your trade here and hold the rest for the full take profit. But this is just in real time showing you guys how these levels work and how you can use them to your advantage. Now, last but not least, let's go into the alerts. Come up here to create alert or press Alt A. For the condition, we're gonna start with the EzAlgo V7, so click that. We have a variety of alerts that you can choose from, starting with the blue trend ribbon flip, which will be when the trend ribbon turns from red to blue, the buy signal, the either buy or sell signal, mild buy or sell signal, etc. You get the point. So if you guys want to set alerts, you can. For example, we'll do buy signal. Always set to once per bar close. And you can name the alert whatever you want, right? Alert name, Ave buy, with the message that says buy signal, EzAlgo. And we also have a ton of alert options on the EzSR V2. We have an alert for when price is at either a support or resistance level, resistance, support, price breaks support or resistance, price breaks resistance, and price breaks support. So for example, if price were to tag a support level, meaning the candle touches the level, you would get alerted for price at support. If price closes above a resistance level, for example, you would get an alert for price breaks resistance. So it's all about when the candle closes. Price is at a support if it touches it, and price breaks support if it closes below it. All right, but that is the full walkthrough for EzAlgo V7 and EzSR V2. If you guys want these indicators, like I said, first link in the description below. We have a ton of new updates coming soon, including our smart money concepts indicator, which is currently in the works, and I'm so excited for you guys to see that, as well as many other updates. We're just getting started. If you guys have any questions, I'm always in the Discord, and we have a 24/7 support team inside the Discord as well. Leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more trading content, and I'll see you guys next video.